Hello. How far are we from the experimental city, and how much money needs to be accumulated for that to happen? And how much money is accumulated now?
Yeah, it would take a lot of money to do the first city or a larger research center. And we would have to find some people who understood the significance of what that first city needs, what the research center could accomplish, a larger one. And as of yet, we have not met anyone. We are not taking donations to do a city because it would just take too many. You couldn't do it that way. So we're trying to reach people by, you know, telling them about what the problems are within this society and what the benefits would be in a resource-based economy, and the need to do a first city. Eventually, we would have to do a first city as a testing ground. Because the cities today are just inefficient, they're stressful, they pollute, that you can't do a resource-based economy within this and maintain all the energy that's needed to run the types of cities that we have today. And they're just not sufficient to live in.
I just want to say that there's no ownership of the city. You don't own houses or property. You live in the building as long as you like. And when the new machine comes in your factory, we call the workers together. We say, you used to work 8 hours a day, now you work 3 hours a day, because machines are helping. And your vacation is not 1 week of a year, but 3 months, and you go on a roller cruise with your family. In other words, everybody gains invention and sharing of ideas. There's no such thing as a private corporation that makes a lot of money on your shortcut. Do you understand? And people worry about a dictatorship. The minute you go to work for any industry today, the minute you punch your time clock, you're under the dictates of that industry. Every industry is a dictatorship. Remember. So you're always in a dictatorship, only it's inefficient. It's not for your benefit, it's for the owners of the industry.
Thank you.